guys, welcome back to my channel. So today we are going to create a duplicate detection rule in Power Apps. So here is a little bit of demo of it. So over here I create two records. So let's create a title and designation developer and email. So a record is created, right? Now, if you create another record with same name, and this usually happens when there are lots of records in your database, and you need to check if there is any duplicate detection, then you can implement this. So duplication detection rule is asking there is another record with the email ID clear cartridge.com. Do you want to ignore, save, update or cancel? So you can simply cancel it or you can update it so that this record is updated. Right now the designation is developer 1. We can make it dev 1 if we put an update on it. And if you want a duplicate record with the same name, then you can just ignore and save. I'll just copy it. So in this tutorial, let's check out how we can make it. So let's start. So first of all, create a gallery. Now we want a list of items to be shown here. I have a list of employees over here. So I want this SharePoint to appear in this gallery. So I'll go to data, I'll go to connector, SharePoint, add a connection, connect, and here it will ask for me the link of the gallery, link of the SharePoint URL. If you already use it, will list down the site here, but you can just put the link, copy from here and put it over here, connect. So there's the link, there's the SharePoint list that we are going to use. I connect it, and on the data source of this gallery I put employee list. Now I put the layout at title body and title subject and body so that we have three data, title, designation and email. All three is shown here. Okay, after this, since we need to fill, the data needs to get in, we will have a form. And again, the data source of this form would be employee list. Now, let's change the layout of this form a bit. Put it at one column, remove the attachments. Okay, great. So when the app is loaded, this form needs to get loaded as well because it will show no items to display. So what I can do is on the on start of this form, I can put new form and name of this form, which is form 2. I can also name it as something like form and call this Intel employees. So run on start, play, and this form will be displayed. So the next thing that I'll do is put a button here so that it submits data into this form. Call it create or maybe save, and then on select or property of this save button, I would put new form and form employee. So what will it do is it will, so title would be designation and QA . So that's our email. I save it. Oops, there is some issue. Okay, so on select, it should not be a new form, but it should be submit form. So save it, we'll add it over here. But as you can see, the form is now disappearing. So what I do is, on success of this form, it will load the form itself, which is new form and form choice. And I also want to show the record being created, so I can put notify and put a message, record has been created, and type would be success. Close this. So now play this and run this once more. It, who's left? Barry's gone, Bruce gone, Diana's gone. And it will show with the notification and the form is reloaded again. Okay, so now we need to do a duplicate detection rule, right? So for that, let's expand this a little so that it looks a little better. Okay, it's good. So let's put a rectangle over here. Before that, I want to delete some of the records, so let's put a delete icon here. Over here, make it a little small. And on select, remove. It out. All right, very good. So let's put a rectangle, or I can just go here and search for rectangle. Make its color black and let's go to its fill, put it at 0.5 or even less, 0.2. There would be a message, so let's put another rectangle. This is better. Make it white. That's good. Align it to center and put a title. Make a font a little larger. Okay. And another text. So the duplicate detection rule would be by using email. So vertical line top so that it does not appear in the middle. So there is another record with email ID, and the email ID is, let's go over here, text, name of the form is form employee, so last submit dot email. Actually, it should be date dot email. Yeah, this should be good, I guess. give few buttons. Load and save. Now there can be maybe just so one is ignore and save, update existing record. Let's just call it update. And next thing is cancel. So let's give the cancel color red or something like this. Okay, so let's click all these and group it so that it's easier. So all this is grouped. On the group section, let's call this group dialog box, and on its visible, let's put show dialog, and on app start we set. So on the screen, on visual, we can put update context. Oh, let's just use set on app start. Now when this is clicked, what I will do is I will search for a new search for the duplicate records here. If it's not found, I'll just create a new record. If it's there, we will this should be part of this group visible. Anyways, so let's come back to here. So we'll select this save, come over here and do some, put some logics. So we'll check we'll look up into the records of employees. So I'm looking up the list of employees and I'm checking if email equals true. So this is my field. So I'm checking if this field dot text, right? So I'm checking if this gives a blank value or not. If this does not give a blank value, it means there is a duplicate record over there. So if it does not give a blank value, we can just submit the form. But if it gives a blank value, what we can do is we will set so dialogues as true. So let's put some values over here. Yeah, let's put chill seems on. And for the duplicate detection sake, I'll just copy this and put it over here. So there is a duplicate detection. So now I can either ignore it, update it, or cancel it. So if I want to ignore and save it, I don't have to do much. I will just submit form on employees and ignore and save. So this needs to be disappear once I click ignore and save. So over here, what I can do is I can set so dialog false. Sadly, it will be submitted again. Okay, not bad. So So let's delete this one and make another James Bond or Stuart. And oops, paste it, save. Now, if I want to update this record, what I can do is I can put in. So what I can do here is I can patch employee list, look up for the same. I can just click on this button and copy this. And okay, so look up is there. So I need to look up a title, update the title. Title would be, this is the title value. Okay, so copy this, come here, yeah, and text. Then I need to update designation, which is over here. And I can copy this, come here and paste it. Email is same, so I don't need to do anything about it. And after this is done, I need to hide this dialog box. So set, so call, sorry, so dialogs is false. I can again need to reset the form as well. So new form, form employees, and this should be good. Update. So John Stewart is now QA. So while we update this, the values here should also need to be clear. So I click on update, and after the new form or before the new form, I can just reset the form, form employees, oops, and then click this update. Okay, this form is clear now. The last part that is left is to cancel it. So save it. Now this cancel should work, right? So I click on this cancel, and over here set so form, so dialog, sorry, and pause it and click on cancel. We can cancel the form, and let's try it out with the other features. So the John Stewart is now James Stewart. Update, James Stewart is there. Need to create a new record for James Stewart, John Stewart. I want a duplicate record. Then test automation. So at this point, I will ignore and save. So guys, hope you like my video. If you like it, please subscribe to my channel and click on the bell notifications to stay updated with all the videos that I upload. Thank you so much for watching.